Being a teenager is hard enough, but these girls are growing up hundreds of kilometres away from their community and culture.
I miss being around my mob, like my cousins, my aunties, uncles, because family is important as well in my life.
16-year-old Riley is from a small town in northwest New South Wales, but this year made the tough choice to move to Sydney.
I miss mum and dad. Phone calls aren't enough.
She's boarding at the Biala Girls Hostel and attending the local public school, hoping that will help her get into university.
My mum doesn't want us to make mistakes in education, and she wants us to have a good life and not a life of struggle.
Where I come from, you don't get a better education as you would if you came to the city.
The boarding house tries to celebrate the girls' heritage and connect them to local elders. Many made the choice to leave with the hope they could one day give back to their people.
I've only come here so then when I go back home, I could be a school teacher up there.
It's just a sense in me that I need to help other people, so becoming a nurse would definitely fulfil that, yeah.
I just want to be that person to make a change in Aboriginal communities.
Indigenous families in regional or remote areas where there are few, if any, secondary school options are instead turning to boarding school. Figures suggest there's been a 50% increase in the number of Indigenous boarders just in the last 5 years.
But research shows the transition to boarding for Indigenous kids is tough, and sometimes there's a high dropout rate.
We've recently done a study with a community in the Northern Territory. Young people were very, very isolated when they went away to school, and most of them actually dropped out within the first year.
These girls are sure they made the right choice and are rising to the challenge. Isabella Higgins, ABC News.